The Attack on Titan Wings of Rebellion visual novel panel. Allow me to introduce myself. My name's Rara. I'm kind of a jack of all trades. And for Wings of Rebellion, I do the artwork. I do the artwork. I do the all the production, the audio engineering, the sound engineering. I write the series itself. It's a spin-off, of course, on Attack on Titan. And I also voice as the original character Nivea, as well as Hanji Zoe. Alright, I think I've already asked, have you guys ever heard of any of the Attack on Titan, the Attack on Titan audio plays, visual novels, etc.? Another one you guys should definitely check out is Survey Corps. I play an original character named Lily in that. So those of you who are wondering what an audio play or a visual novel is, well, an audio play is a media of storytelling, where basically you do the narrative audio elements, like there's voice acting, engineering, there's the sound effects, all the music and everything. In the Attack on Titan community, we also do visual elements, such as there's graphics for the subtitles, there's character portraits. Again, I do that every single bit of that for Wings of Rebellion. The only difference between this and what a visual novel is, which is basically sort of like an interactive game of that, this just doesn't have the interactive elements. It's basically kind of on autoplay and you don't have the options. So for the Wings of Rebellion plot, it's a fan-made spin-off, of course. It's featuring Marco Bott, who is a soldier who was once proclaimed deceased in the Battle of Trust. So not only is he alive in this series, as well as Petra Rahl, he also is a Titan shifter, which is going to be really super fun for you guys. So while they're all, the Survey Corps is making it their duty to figure out what's going on with Marco, very much akin to like Aaron's situation, and also what exactly had happened to him. Not only is the 104th Survey Corps in this, but also there are some original characters, some from the veteran 100th class, as well as the 105th, which is the newer graduates. Alright, so without further ado, I have a feature presentation. It's basically a little recap series of episodes 1 through 4. I did want to mention, number one, that some of the voice actors have changed throughout the series. The series has been going on since about 2014. So there's some cast changing, so I apologize if that's a little bit jarring to hear, because there's going to be different people for one character. Also, there is definitely some strong language. There's not a lot of more like intimate situations or anything like that, but it definitely has a lot of curse words. And a little bit of blood here and there. Not quite as gory as the actual series, but I hope you guys really enjoy this so much.
Major Hanji Zoe?
Don't worry, she doesn't bite. We'll take the shackles off as soon as we can, okay?
As soon as we're safe. Marco, watch me.
Yes, sir.
Don't look Major Zoe in the eye for more than 5 seconds. Always nod when she makes a statement. And if she goes off on a tangent, don't say anything. Mind the letter.
What?
Marco Bott, the name of a soldier once believed to be deceased, now stands in front of Captain Levi's recon squad after being revealed in the form of a Titan himself. Dazed and confused, the new shifter himself has yet to disclose any information on his controversial reunion. How is he still alive, and how did he acquire such extraordinary abilities akin to Eren Yeager's? Despite Marco's current lack of answers, the Survey Corps will admittedly seek the solution, regardless of the means.
Thank you. buttons right after it. It's not a technique for us. Great. What else happened to it? It's deteriorating? Wait. I think I see it. It can't be. Are you human?
It appears so. Another shifter.
He is right. I can't judge Marco's situation yet. We barely know anything about what happened to him. We're not all like her. But at least this time I have a chance to find out what's going on with Marco.
I don't need to hear this from you, Titan Shifter. You're just suspicious. And we all know what you almost
did. Please. You think I'm going to sit here and listen to the both of you talk shit about people you don't know anything about?
Hey, guys, this really isn't the time for this.
Just shut the hell up and get back to cleaning. Before Captain Levi hears you yell it, he loses it when he sees her slacking off.
Yeah, I should fancy some more bruises to go with that freckled face to show up. You're awfully familiar with those roundhouse kicks of his, after all.
How dare you! Do you want to say that again, Pony Boy?
Wallowing in his ignorance.
Wait, Nevaeh, it's not the right way. Where are you going?
Jeez, it's hard to believe someone's accusing me for how talented she is. By 4 years in the Survey Corps.
John, that's enough. Dominating and then get to you for a second. Are you alright?
Actually, Levi's not going to be happy about this fighting at all. I've already disappointed him so much today, and if it weren't for Marco saving her, I truly would have.
Krista, that wasn't your fault. You know that. She's alive, and that's all mattered to her. You were making mistakes.
Ellen's right. I mean, you did kind of mess up pretty bad back there, and Major Al almost got eaten. She still made it.
Omar, that wasn't the most appropriate response.
Levi, you bring me another Titan Shifter, and you don't expect me to write a full observation? Where did he come from? How does the shifting mechanism work? What are his goals? His capabilities? No, you must let me have him! I've got to find out!
Listen, Four Eyes. Marco Bot isn't some guinea pig for you to poke at. He's a frightened kid who's at the brink of hysterics. He doesn't know where this power comes from or how it works.
And that's why I'm here, to find out. I can just taste the sweet revelation.
Oh dear. Hanji, if I may, tonight may not be the best night to conduct an observation on his abilities yet. So far, we can assume he isn't a direct threat. But if we push him too far, he may become catatonic.
For all we know, his transformation could be triggered by fear. We can't risk an accident over you traumatizing the brat.
Where did you get this scar? Marco, was it?
This scar? I don't remember exactly. Recently, we've discovered that Eren Yeager has regenerative ability. Not only do his wounds heal rapidly, but he is also able to reconstruct irreplaceable body parts, such as teeth and limbs.
So how exactly did you get this scar? And why is it still present?
Are not all shifters capable of this restoration? Oh, Levi, what do you think?
I told you to take your filthy mitts off of him.
Regenerative? That doesn't sound good.
Marco, you're not in any trouble. We just need to find out anything we can about what happened to you. Believe me, we want to help you just as much as we need you.
I remember running through the thick stench of smoke.
Don't you get it? We're the only ones who can stop this.
This doesn't make any of this right! Do this! This goes against everything I know! Everything I believe!
I should have known better than to trust you.
Are you sure that's a good idea? So soon before we leave. Shouldn't we take him to Commander Erwin first?
What, so he can stare the boy down with his massive eyebrows?
Hanji-so!
We'll be meeting with the Commander before our departure to the walls. I need to record any details I can before then for a proper briefing.
Oh, don't worry, my sweet freckled subject. You won't be in any notable pain. It's just a physical exam.
Fine. But if you freaking out any more than usual, I'll kick the shade glasses right off your face, Four Eyes. We can't risk any accidents. You and Petra are dismissed for now.
Very well, Captain. Krista will be here to have supper with you. Okay, Marco?
I'm not staying with the others, right? That's okay. Thank you.
Lens will be keeping watch of you for the remainder of the evening. I've spoken with the other recruits, and she's least likely to stir up any trouble with you. You won't be seeing Kirstein or Desjardins tonight.
I didn't want to die with that flaky bastard anyway.
What? Nivea, what are you doing here?
Man! I didn't think it'd be that easy taking down a Titan.
They appear to be moving faster than anticipated, but I can handle them one at a time.
That's right. The invincible Levi always prevails.
Hell yeah! Those Titans ain't no match for you, big brother.
Well, the sooner we're out of this mess, the better.
Oh, don't worry about it too much. Get it all figured out, right?
right. Big Brother, just you wait. We'll be sitting pretty on the surface in no time. We'll have our own house and lots of money. We can go outside and feel the sunlight all we want, and we'll never go hungry. Right, Big Brother?
Just keep on your toes, you two. We'll make it as long as we stick together. I won't let anything happen to you two, so long as I draw breath.
Leave it to you to make things sound so grim. Just cheer up a bit, will ya? Before your face raises up and people start calling you the constipated Levi.
Hey, shut up, Barlin. Big Brother's just being careful. One of us has gotta be realistic, you know? He worries about us, that's all.
Don't start squabbling, or I'll kick both of your asses.
Alright, alright.
You know, guys, I've been thinking.
Whoa, take it easy there, Isabel. Thinking? That can't be good.
Can it, Barlin? What I was trying to say is, going beyond the walls, it's kinda like how we used to dream of leaving the underground slums, you know? I don't know if it's weird, but maybe that offer your hearts to humanity stuff isn't a load of crap after all. Isn't, Big Brother?
Storm's coming. Shit. Rotten luck.
So, you and me there.
Ugh, don't get me started.
Okay, then. I won't ask. I think she might have a point about the incoming storm.
You're kidding me? You want to talk about the weather, of all things?
John, I was just...
No, even! Why did I even hope for any better? Of course you'd sit there and act like nothing's changed.
You're not being fair. Give me a chance to explain.
Oh, please! I'm the one who's being unfair? Oh, sure. I mean, it's not like you just up and vanished out of our lives, declared Kelvin action, and then walks back in and try to act like it's nothing.
What do you mean I'm acting like it's nothing? John, don't you see the shackles? I'm under strict observation. I was interrogated, and subjected to a physical exam.
So I'm supposed to just act like nothing happened and be happy with no answers? That's bullshit, Marco. You were nearly eaten whole by those. And now you're one of them?
John, I'm sorry. I'm sorry you had to see that. I don't even know how it happened. I just thought I died too. But I'm here now, and I'm trying my damned hardest to pick up the pieces. Don't you realize it?
So what were you doing in Era? Why were you outside the remaining colony? Marco, you could've... Why didn't you try to reach me? I could've helped somehow. Don't you trust in me, Marco?
I do trust you. But right now, I need you to do the same for me. I'm sorry all this happened. I swear it. I'm not hiding anything from you or from anybody. I just can't confirm anything yet. And until I do, I don't want to risk putting anyone in danger from a lack of answers.
More questions to outweigh the answers. Thanks a lot, Marco.
Like that. What if you fall? Hey, wait! switching places and then getting out of these shackles.
Hanji, stop fooling around and get back in position.
Oh, Levi, I do hope this trial goes swiftly. Why? How that been conducted under examinations of your passes?
Yes, I'm sure they'll also fill out their forms for you and your new Titan hobby along with. I'll listen to your squabbling over him after the trial. But right now, I need you to focus on surviving and shoot glasses.
All the more reasons are anticipated. Oh, I can't wait for the opportunity! Yahoo!
Major, watch out! Major, it was fortunate for you not to stay in position.
I'm starting to realize why Mogul always smells like a whiskey.
Aaron, you know the drill. Don't transform into a Titan unless Commander Irwin or myself order you to. You may have more control over your Titan form, but we must stay prepared.
Yes, sir!
Right.
God's sake, Skullamar, keep your eyes focused in front of you.
Yes, sir. Sorry, sir.
Don't let it get to you, Skullamar. You're very capable with a 3D movie gear already, so you'll adapt quickly. Just try to relax the best you can.
Thanks, Kasa. It really means a lot coming from you.
What's that supposed to
mean? Oh, no. I meant it in a good way, honest. You're such a skilled soldier and all, and I really appreciate the advice you and the Navy gave me. Jesus, father, you're right today, right?
Titans are approaching. Everyone, stay on guard.
Ain't that a threat? Soon as Mike smells of them, they get away from us.
Shit! It's starting to fog. Their storms kind of sound like thunder, too.
Squad leader, where are they coming from?
West of us. We've got ways to the wilds. Keep course straight and steady.
What? Fucking up already?
Shit, it's getting thick.
Light your lanterns to detect your comrades. You'll see the lights if you run off course.
It's abnormal! Captain! It's coming from the left side!
Draw your weapons!
It must be a crawler.
A crawler? Oh, I haven't seen one in ages!
How can you tell?
Listen to the footing. Lighter and faster, but two pairs of stars, one by one.
They're very quick, so be careful! We can't reach its knees so easily since it runs on all fours.
Spread out towards the right! Gullamar, switch positions with me. I'll take care of the crawler. Here it comes! Aaron, Gullamar, pull back!
There it is!
Watch out, Captain!
Pretty lucky. In a sense.
Everyone, stand by. A few more Titans are on their way. Petra, Titans are closing in from each side.
Captain, multiple Titans are approaching. What is your command?
Keep your weapons drawn. Eric, stand by alongside Gullibar and pull back towards the wagon. Mikasa, take Eren's position behind me. I'll advance upon the first Titan. I'm trusting you to take care of the second one if it follows close.
Understood, sir. Be prepared to attack in case one of them is further off from this Gullibar.
Gotcha! We can do it! Right, Eren?
Of course we can! Captain Levi!
Mikasa and Don can handle the rest, Eren. If something should happen to the wagon Marco sent, that will be your cue to act.
But what about Marco? We can't just... Marco, stay in the wagon! Can't be helped!
But people are dying!
Marco, it's not your responsibility. Please, let us handle it. Don't interfere.
There isn't much any of us can do when you want, Marco. I know you want to help, but this is the only way. You're so useless!
Another one's coming from behind us. Nevaeh, switch positions with me.
Yes, sir! Oh,
wait!
Why are you pulling back so far?
I can handle it. Just move forward and stay in formation. Nevaeh, you and I are going to slash its knees. Connie, Sasha, spread out and stand by.
Yes, sir. Sasha, you know the drill.
We got this! Prepare it!
I've heard about your skills from my commander, Nevaeh. You specialize in agility, correct?
Yes, but I can...
You lack discipline, and our visibility is far too limited. I'll kill the Titan. You just focus on Kunigan's knee and returning to your post.
Thank you.
Tishalo! Get out of the way!
Strongest soldier.
I'm so nervous. I don't feel worthy enough to be in his squad.
Don't sweat it, doll. We're gonna be in good hands, trust me. And I wouldn't let anything happen to someone as sweet as you.
Just be sure to be on your best behavior, everyone. You're coming back from an important mission from Era. And it appears they've suffered some casualties.
Oh no. Does that have to do with the wounded Titan room I keep hearing about?
This time around, but if you guys have any questions, I'm going to be opening the Q&A session. If you have any questions about Wings of Rebellion, if you have any questions on how you can get into audio play or visual novel production for Attack on Titan, hit me up. I also remember that I have a little advertisement on here. I am actually looking for cast members and crew. Like I've said before, I've done Wings of Rebellion since about 2014, and I have been a one-man army. That being said, I also work a full-time job as a manager, so of course I haven't had a whole lot of time to resume picking up on this. I'm working on episode 7 at the moment. There's 6 episodes out right now. You can catch the full episodes on YouTube, but if you guys, anybody would be interested in doing anything with that, voice acting, audio engineering, video editing, clean up, anything like that, even art, definitely hit me up. I've given everybody my business cards as well as bookmarks that have the URL of Wings of Rebellion on it. If you guys, like I said, I don't have a full cast. Usually we do like character improv. I know I don't have as big of a room as I usually do, but if somebody wants to volunteer to do character Q&A with me, I could take one or two and you guys can answer character questions. I'm sure you guys are pretty interested in Attack on Titan to know them pretty well. It's entirely up to you guys. But otherwise, if you guys want to get into voice acting, anything like that, if you have any questions about it, hit me up. This is the time.
Yeah.
Oh, thank you so much.
Do you guys have any questions for Hanji by chance? Because you know I'm absolutely invested in the wounded type.
Yes, Your Honor. Marco followed his orders accordingly.
I understand, however, that Marco conflicted with Armin Allard and Mobley Burner. And what of the other scout you claim Marco had allegedly spared? Did Marco complicate the situation further?
Order, Chief Dog. While it's not possible to interrogate the other scout, I will now hear Armin Allard to witness stand, please.
It wasn't his fault that
John, be quiet.
Don't tell me to shut up. Aaron, you are the one
who... Both of you, keep it down. We know what actually happened, but you have to trust Armin to tell them the truth.
I know. Look, I know things got a little more than wrong at that point, but we cannot mess this up for him. Okay?
What about the shifting then? Earmarks!
They'll hear you.
Armin Allard. Please inform us on what happened after the scout was seized by the Chaser Titan.
Yes, Your Honor. While it is true that the three of us had some complications in the wagon, Marco's actions hold a great amount of benefits for our survival and return to the colonies.
Concludes our panel. Thank you guys so much for joining me today. I really appreciate it. Usually, before you guys go, I did want to mention, I usually get this asked to me when I do voice acting panels and stuff. If you guys are interested in singing, specifically anything to do with Vocaloid or if you've heard of it with Taite, tomorrow in the International Room, I am hosting the Idolize Me Introduction to Online Idol Community panel. So, if you guys are interested in that, go check that out. I hope to see you guys there. Thank you so much.
Bye.